This is the time of year when thousands of Americans find themselves going to the gym, often for the first time in years. Today, our fitness expert, Wes Cole, is here with the answers to some of your beginner questions, if you're not 9 months pregnant, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, we have some viewers who have some questions for you. First, we want to start off with Greg. He asks, do I lift weights before or after doing cardio?
Well, you know, common knowledge is what they say in all the books. They say you want to lift weights before you do cardio because you want to, you know, definitely have your strength, because strength training, you know, you want to really focus on that. But it's been my experience, if you're new to the gym, if you haven't worked out in years, you have to be real careful. If you, you know, go in the gym and you do 3 or 4 sets of squats and lunges, and then you try to hop on the elliptical, your legs can tend to be a little rubbery.
Like jelly. And
so, you know, you want to be real careful because it can actually make you a little unstable. And I've seen some people, you know, wipe out on the treadmills and the ellipticals. So, you know, if you can, I'd recommend if you're not in really good shape, maybe separate the days or even consider doing cardio first. Cardio doesn't build a lot of muscle, but it builds some capillary density, maybe give you a baseline of fitness before you start something real serious.
But I mean, really, isn't the important thing that you do them both?
You need to do them both. You really do. It's important. But the important thing, most important thing, is not to wipe out on the treadmill your first time back.
So. That's true. Yeah, we don't want to go to the hospital. All right, now next we have a question from Missy. She asks, how many reps should I do when I'm weight training?
You need, especially if you're getting started, you need to do lightweights. You know, 12 to 15 repetitions, more than anything for practice. Lunges, squats, but it's like any other. It's like anything else. It's a skill. You need to really get that down. Now, a lot of people say this is not going to recruit all the large muscle fibers. It's not going to build the strength. You have to remember that some of the world's most elite Olympic weightlifters, they, you know, their stories, they started with a broomstick for years. Mm-hmm. You're building a good foundation, a good technique right now. It's important to remember that heavy weights, they don't hurt people. It's poor alignment and poor technique. So you're building good habits now, and you're basically getting your body ready for some more serious stuff in the future.
All right, sounds good. Now we have a question from Aaron. He asks, what is the simplest way to work out? Wow, it's a loaded question.
Well, you know, it's not real complicated. I tell people all the time, you know, working out, it's not rocket science. One of the simplest things to do is not focus on what I like to call the Lego method, you know, working your biceps and triceps. Instead, focus on movements. Beth's going to come on out here, and she's going to just give you an example of a full upper body workout. And what she's doing, she's focused on an angle. You have a vertical press, mm-hmm. and that works your triceps, that works your shoulders, and you go right into a vertical pull. Okay, she's doing an upright row. That's working your shoulders, that's working your trapezius, and then she goes into a horizontal pull, just like so. Mm-hmm. And then she just finishes off with a horizontal push, just like that.
Okay.
And very good, Beth, thank you. Doing all these, maybe finishing up with maybe a rotational or something like that, that's pretty, I hope she doesn't drop that. Very good, thank you, Beth. Focusing on the movements, it's important to remember that even though we have a lot of muscle groups, there's only so many ways the body can move. Right. Focusing on the vertical press, vertical pull, horizontal press, you have a full body, upper body workout. Focusing on movements is the real new way to train now. Instead of the Lego method, make sure you hit your triceps and biceps. You can be in the gym forever.
Right, and that's a quicker way to do it as well.
It is, much quicker.
All right, if you have a question you'd like Wes to answer, go to the Weekend Morning section of our website, kjrh.com, or you can call Wes. He's at 918-749-0960, or visit his gym. He's on 46th, just east of Sheridan. Now over to Taft.